Hello, good afternoon everyone. Welcome to my next video, and the video is regarding beginner bioinformatics virtual course for day one. So today I will be organizing a virtual session regarding the beginner bioinformatics course. So before proceeding towards the beginner bioinformatics course, I just want to take you towards the overview about the what is actually the bioinformatics course it is. So bioinformatics, it is an integrated biological concepts with information and technology to study the biological system. So what we are going to cover in this today's session, we are going to explore some introduction regarding the bioinformatics field, and we are going to see how we are going to use some theoretical and computational methodology which are relevant to the mining of the data and information from the large data set of biological origin. Whereas bioinformatics is also used for the combined theory, and also we are going to see some practical aspects to solve the research problems in the field of bioinformatics. So it is really a very nice course, and it really help us to integrate a large amount of data sets, and this data sets has been used to integrate the bioinformatics course and applied for problem solving environments. So before proceeding towards, I just want to introduce myself. Myself, Niloufar Sheikh. I am a PhD scholar in the field of bioinformatics itself from MIT ADT University. And my area of interest is I'm working in the field of drug designing, molecular docking, data mining. And also I'm interested in the field of oncoomics, where it carries different techniques, that is genomics, metabolomics, proteomics, transcriptomics. And based on this study, I'm also interested in the field of biomarker designing for cancer, which includes precision medicine for cancer. Whereas I'm also interested in the field of cancer informatics, big data analysis, machine learning, AI based for compute care for cancer. So I'm recently working on these topics. So before proceeding towards the beginning bioinformatics course, I just want to make your overview. What is the goal of this presentation? So I'm going to provide you certain definitions regarding the what is bioinformatics course it is, and we are going to have some questions. We are going to ask some questions regarding why to study this particular bioinformatics course, what are the accomplishment and what are the challenges exist in the field of bioinformatics. So bioinformatics is a unified discipline form from the combination of biology and computer science, and also the information technology. Whereas it is an integrated study, it will cover the biological data, computer science data, and statistical data. And it is used for the mathematical, statistical, and computational methods that really aim us to solve the biological problem using DNA or the amino acid sequence related to the information, means related to your study regarding the diseases. So what is done in the bioinformatics? Bioinformatics, it is used for the designing and the development and also implementations of tools and database, which are really enables us, the users, to use the efficient amount of data and manage different data types of information, such as various databases, integrated mapping information. So bioinformatics has certain level of study in the field of in silico analysis. In silico analysis is nothing but the computational work which carried out for solving the biological query using different mathematical or statistical techniques. So if you have a domain knowledge regarding biology, yes, you can take bioinformatics field and explore your further research work. Whereas in statistical domain, mathematical domain, even engineers can also enroll in the field of bioinformatics. Chemistry background, biochemistry background, computer science background. So all can use this particular platform, that is bioinformatics course, and they can explore their research work or the area of interest in the field of bioinformatics. So basically bioinformatics run in the unit of information which deals with DNA analysis and their sequence analysis, RNA analysis, protein structure analysis, what are the evolutionary study regarding the proteins, pathway analysis, interactions and mutations. So this overall units we are going to study in overall flow of bioinformatics course or in the field of bioinformatics. So we are going to see what are the DNA, what type of mutations, what is actually the DNA contain, that is ATGC pair of, and what are the coding and non-coding genes, what are the alterations in that. And RNA, you are going to see what are the splice variants involved, what are the tissue specific expressions, what are the structures, and you are also going to see what are the experimental data involving in thousands of genes simultaneously. Whereas in RNA, you will get the information regarding the DNA sheet data, microarray data set, which is really important for the study and analysis, expression data, and so on. Whereas in protein, you can also study based on the proteome of an organism, or you can get the data with respect to 2D gel, electrophoresis data sets, mass spectroscopy data sets. You can get the 2D structure, 3D structure, and 4D structure of the proteins with related to the interaction study. In protein, so basically everybody has known that protein is 20-letter amino acid sequences are there, and it is in the form of string, and the basic protein amino acid average length, it is around 300 amino acids involved, for example in the bacteria. So protein has divided into the certain domains regarding with respect to your study of interest. The protein's 3D structure is also included in study in the field of bioinformatics for designing any drug or druggable targets. So you will get the, you are also going to explore the proteins and their 3D structures. So why we are using bioinformatics? The bioinformatics is a field when one can explore and use the amount of data, as it is a continuous data, and use those large amount of data to solve the biological problems, and also see the, what are the informations which are necessary that are used for the computers for catalyzing and the driving of this information. The more goal of this perspective in the experimental designs, as we have we move from the one set of the genes, or we are study in the form of proteins or overall the disease paradigm. So one can use and explore this study for disease solving or for their research work. So before proceeding, I just want to show you some overview regarding the history of bioinformatics. So when the term has been introduced in 1970, the term of bioinformatics has been coined, whereas in 1990, Human Genome Project has been started, and it has been completed in 2003, that is Human Genome Project. Whereas the Human Genome Project has been launched in 1990, and whereas in 2001, the Human Genome Project, that is 300 megabase pair, has been published. So this is a certain overview regarding the bioinformatics history. So why actually there is a need of bioinformatics? Why it is so important? Yes, it is worth it, and it is also in value of money. So every industry today has a need, candidate who has knowledge about bioinformatics field, because in bioinformatics, a bioinformatician has knowledge regarding the domain with respect to disease of their interest. They have the biological knowledge, they have computational knowledge, they have certain statistical knowledge. So bioinformaticians have really used in this industry, even as well as in the field of academics. So what the bioinformatics pipelines and applications are involved? Bioinformatics study is nothing but the carry of the molecular biology of the central dogma of life. So you are going to explore the information technology in the form of high throughput screening, next generation sequencing. There is a boom in this industry nowadays, and sequence alignment analysis and the interpretations, which is really required for interpretations of any gene or protein alignment and the sequences, gene finding, genome mapping and assembly, protein structure alignment and predictions, which is really important in the field of drug designing, prediction of gene expression and protein-protein interactions, which is really important for the interaction study, evolution modeling, drug discovery and development in the biopharmaceuticals. So this is the overall flow and application of bioinformatics in the field. So what is the scope of bioinformatics? Bioinformatics is the application of computer technology to get the information that can store in a certain type of biological data. So it offers analysis softwares, data studies, provides tools and modelings for visualization and interpretations of data. So does bioinformatics has future? Yes, definitely. In terms of who will be doing bioinformatics is the future. The answer is you will be. So you have better to get the gift. So anyone is doing any molecular biology or any domain oriented, they have certain skills regarding their study. If they, you have bioinformaticians and you are expert in the field of drug designing, omics, microbial genome, genetic engineering, gene engineering, personalized medicines and other applications. So here you can see the market of bioinformatics globally in 2019. Whereas here I have ranked certain domains with respect to bioinformatics study, that is genomics, that is based on the NGS data analysis, drug designing in the field of chemoinformatics, proteomics, transcriptomics and so on. Here you can see the graph which has been the bar plot which has been plotted based on the domain study of bioinformaticians. And here you can see the product and services based on the 2016 to they have plotted based on the prediction of 2023, how vastly the bioinformaticians have used in the product and services and the publications regarding the bioinformatics work. Is bioinformatics has a good career? If you have an experts and training and the area of interest of data science, the life of science has an area of bioinformatics which is booming and continuously grow with high demand and excellent salary. So good luck for the bioinformaticians. How do I start learning bioinformatics? Here is a path that I would recommend you for the beginner for the bioinformatics. Start foundation in the field of your interest in the Python and R or Java languages. Do small projects, or you can use certain bioinformatics data sets to analyze different domain oriented. So here you can see you have to explore certain computer knowledge and you have to explore the data based on your domain of your interest. Which is better, bioinformatics or biotechnology? Many of the students who are bachelors, they definitely ask this questions for choosing the bioinformatics field. So yeah, bioinformatics is really good because it will integrate the data sets with respect to biotechnological data or the computational data sets. So it is an integrated field. So that's why bioinformatics has a broad requirement regarding in the field of industry or academics. What programming languages should I learn for bioinformatics? You should have to learn Python, R, Java to use the languages and learn for the right of the bioinformatics, because here you can do certain data analysis, running some statistical test, making plots for visualizations. So you have to be aware of certain computer knowledges or programming knowledges regarding Python, R. Which skills are needed for bioinformatics? So you have to be first should be have domain knowledge about any field, that is your form statistic, mathematical or engineering background. So you should have first domain knowledge and how you can implement those domain knowledge in the field of bioinformatics. So in today's industries, the requirement of high throughput sequencing, next generation sequencing, omics data analysis, computational genomics, and so on. So what is the aim of bioinformatics? To improve, to contain and utilize the database, develop better tools that use for data generations and annotations and also visualizations concepts, to develop and improve the tools for representing, that is in the field of visualizations and interpretations for the users, and to manage the data sets. So goals of the bioinformatics. So now the goals of bioinformatics have used for the various fields, including the pattern recognition, sequence alignment, gene finding, drug designing field, protein structure alignment, gene expression data, and so on. So necessary skills you require is you have to require knowledge in the field of molecular biology, statistical knowledge, mathematical knowledge for developing an algorithms. You should have to communicate the biological problems with the computer scientist. Working knowledge in the field of bioinformatics tools, you should have to be aware about the command line, programming skills, and so on. So in which field you can work, that is a specialized field within the form of computational biology, genomics, proteomics, bioprogramming, chemoinformatics, structural biology, that is in the form of pathways, chemoinformatics in the field of drug designing, system biology, pharmacogenomics study, and so on. So major area of bioinformatics, you can work in the computationally evolutionary biology, sequence analysis, genome annotations, analysis of regulations, and also in the comparative genomics in the field of cancer. So bioinformatics has been defined in various forms in the field of drug designing, sequence alignment, gene prediction, protein-protein interaction. So bioinformatics has certain databases, whereas one of the databases was created an insulin protein sequence database. So likewise, gathering the data, mining those data, and integrating those data into the single platform, so user can utilize those data sets. So these are the importance of bioinformatics field. So bioinformatics database are used to analyze, organize those database, which can enable the users for the interpretations very easily. So by giving any query, one can utilize those data and analyze those data sets. So certain algorithms are also being used in the bioinformatics. One of the algorithms, for example, hidden Markov models, Smith-Waterman's algorithms, Niedermann-Wolsch algorithms, it has been used in the BLAST program for the sequence alignment study. So one can use those data sets and algorithms for analysis of the data sets. Certain sequence databases are also available where you can extract the nucleic acid sequence or the protein sequence and store in your computer for further analysis and interpretations. Sequence databases have been classified into the genome sequence database, nucleic acid sequence database, protein sequence database, and certain other databases has been categorized based on the primary database, secondary database, and composite database. So here you can see the different database with the gene identifier, accession numbers, organism, literature data set, and what are the sequences has been available. So type of nucleic acid sequence database is in the primary nucleic acid database, where you can find the sequences, and it has been linked with respect to GenBank, PDBJ, and EMBL data. It is being integrated data sets. So this is the broad application towards the bioinformatics field. One can work in the field of genomics data sets for analysis of large data sets, and further they can move in the structural genomics aspects, functional genomics aspects, or nutritional genomics aspects, and so on. So major area is also includes proteomics study, genomics drug designing and chemoinformatics in the field of drug designing, which is really important. Molecular phylogenetic analysis they can use for drug modifications, and one can also use in omics study also. So there is a broad application of bioinformatics. One can retrieve and search based on their interest. There are the different flavors of bioinformatics. Yes, so sequence analysis, annotations, data analysis, computational biology, structural bioinformatics study, and so on. So this is the broad application. They can study the genomic study, proteomic study, system biology study, or phenotypic study also. They can work, there is in the form of image analysis and their integrations of the cancer tests. So bioinformatics has a broad area. They can use different biological data sets and computational tools by using different programming knowledges. So computational biology in in silico bioinformatics, they can include comparative homology modeling study, phylogenetic analysis, protein structure predictions, which is really important, protein folding problems, microarray data analysis, and drug discovery or protein study. So internet and bioinformatics, because it is in silico based approach, so you can use different data sets by using different versions, Windows on Linux, and use different softwares and tools. So it will also have certain statistical, that is data sets, that is biostatistic algorithms. They have different sequence alignment and prediction algorithms available. They have certain p-values for the prediction and analysis. So a vast amount of data sets and resources are available for the data analysis of bioinformatics. So certain biological databases are available in the form of bibliography, that is a literature database is available. There is PubMed database, taxonomical databases used for the classification of data, nucleic acid database for the DNA information study, genomic data, proteomic database, and so on. So this is a primary database which includes EMBL database, GenBank, DDBJ, SwissProt, TRMBL, PIR data for the primary database for analysis of gene or proteins sequence and their data sets. Secondary database includes the ProCytes, PFAM database, Blox database, and PRINCE database. Composite database includes NRBD, DB, OWL. This type of databases are being included in composite database. So DDBJ, EMBL, GenBank are the integrated database. How to become a bioinformatician? So when you have to become a bioinformatician, you should have a knowledge, domain knowledge. You should have a computation with the Linux version, because for analyzing a large amount of data sets, that is a big data set, you require Linux version, and to integrate the data and download the large amount of data by using command line. And one should have a knowledge regarding the programming languages, that is Python, Perl, R, Java, etc. So you can create your account for seeing that what are the actually bioinformaticians has been working in the field of omics approach, drug designing, genomics part, that is anxious state analysis, what are the different techniques and tools they have been using. So these are the certain overview about what is bioinformatics, what are the applications in the field of industry and academic use, how you can utilize your bioinformatician course and include for the study of large amount of data sets and use for the disease finding environment. So this is a little bit more assignment so that you can ask about what is actually the bioinformatics and why do people are considering it an interdisciplinary subject. Interdisciplinary subject because it will include certain integrated data sets, as I have discussed in previous slides. So one should have asked this question to yourself. Then only you can build your interest in the field of bioinformatics and you will explore more on in the field of bioinformatics. So next question is, what is the necessary skills required for the bioinformatics study? should have the skill of programming language, should have skill about the domain knowledge, and you should have to know a little bit about the history of bioinformatics so that you can get awareness about what they have actually worked on. And what are the application that is a major area of application in the field of bioinformatics? What are the major area of research in the field of bioinformatics? What are the actually industry want from bioinformaticians? This type of questions should be included in this particular assignment so you can get a more interest in the field of bioinformatics. So thank you all the participants who has joined in for today's session of bioinformatics. Thank you once again.